Determine the cost of capital of ABC Limited using book value and market value weights from the following information. We have source book value, market value. Equity share is 1.2 crore book value, market value 2 crore. Retained earnings 30 lakh book value, market value nothing. Preference shares 9 lakh book value, market value 10,40,000. Debentures 36 lakh book value, market value is 33,75,000. You have additional information. Equity shares are quoted at rupees 130 per share, and a new issue priced at rupees 125 per share will be fully subscribed. Flotation cost will be rupees 5 per share. Question 2 or information 2. Dividend during the previous 5 years, dividend have steadily increased from 10.6 to 14.19 per share. Dividend at the end of the current year is expected to be rupees 15 per share. Information 3. 15% preference shares with face value of rupees 100 would realize rupees 105 per share. Information 4. Debentures. The company proposes to issue 11-year 15% debentures, but the yield on debentures of similar maturity and risk class is 16%. Flotation cost is 2%. Information 5. Corporate tax rate is 35%, IGNOR dividend tax. Now with this information, we have to calculate weighted average cost of capital, and we have to calculate this back using book value weights and market value weights. So for calculating weighted average cost of capital, we should calculate cost of each and every source of financing. First, let's start with the cost of equity. We'll have a working note. How do we calculate cost of equity? Cost of equity is equal to D1 divided by P0 plus G. If there is a flotation cost, that should be deducted from P0. We know D1 is equal to 15, P0 is 125, that is the market price with this issue, and issue cost is 5, that is the flotation cost. So we have D1, P0 and F, we don't have G. So how do we know the G? G is nothing but the growth. And in question, we have information that dividend has grown from 10.6 to 14.19. That is, on 10.6, some growth rate has been applied every year for 5 years. So that has resulted in 14.19. So G is nothing but 10.6 multiplied by growth rate for 5 years, which had now become equal to 14.19. That is, 1.r to the power of 5 is equal to 14.19 divided by 10.6, and this gives the value as 1.338. So on the left hand side we have 1 plus r to the power of 5, and on the right side we have 1.338. Here r is the growth rate, so this value we can find by looking at the table in 5 years. We have to see by looking at 5 years which percentage gives the value of 1.338. Now by looking at the table, we get the value at 6%. So 6% gives the value of 1.338. So the growth rate is 6%. So now we have all the information, so we can find what is the cost of equity, which is 15 divided by 125 minus 5 plus the 6%, so 0.06. So the cost of equity is 18.5%. So we have found the cost of equity, that is the first source. The second source is cost of retained earnings. Here the cost is calculated in the same way, except that there will not be any flotation cost. So cost of retained earnings will be D1 divided by P0 plus G. We know D1 is equal to 15, P0 is 125 and G is 6%. So cost of retained earnings is 18%. Next we'll go to working note 3, that is cost of preference shares. Here we don't have any information about the redemption, then cost of preference shares will be very simple. It will be dividend divided by the market value of the preference shares. And dividend, what is D1 for preference shares? The face value into the preference dividend rate. Face value is 100 into 15% would give the D1, and it is 15, and we have P0 is equal to 105. So cost of preference shares is equal to 15 divided by 105, so we have it as 14.3%. So we have cost of preference shares. Next we'll have cost of debentures. Only in debentures we have a twist in the problem. Because in the question, it is mentioned debenture interest, that is the coupon rate, is 15%. But the market rate is 16% and the coupon rate of the company is 15%, which is less than market rate. That is, company is offering at a discount. So the 15% on 100, that is the debenture interest of 15% on 100, that is 15, if it is equated with a market rate of 16%, it would give a market price of 93.75. So you are raising at 93.75, the instrument worth 100. Apart from that, there will be flotation cost also, that is 2, that has to be deducted. So the net proceeds from debenture is 91.75. This information is very much important because this is a redeemable debenture. There is a redemption value. We should know net proceeds, and net proceeds is 91.75. So cost of debentures is I multiplied by 1 minus T plus redemption value minus net proceed divided by debenture life divided by the average of redemption value plus net proceeds, or average of redemption value and net proceeds. So fitting the value, interest is 15 multiplied by post-tax effect plus 100, which is the redemption value, minus 91.75 divided by the life of debenture, which is 11 years, divided by the average. So cost of debenture is equal to 11%. So now we have cost of all sources of finance. So we'll go ahead and compute the cost of capital using the book value and market value. So first, let us list out the sources. The sources are equity, retained profits, preference shares, and debentures. What about the book value? We have the information. Here the values are considered as weights, and we have the information in the question about the book value. Equity is 1.2 crore, so I am calling it as 120. Retained profits is 30 lakh, so it is 30. Preference shares is 9 lakh, and debentures are 36 lakh. The total is 195. But when it comes to market value, we have market value only for equity. There is no bifurcation between the equity shares and retained profits. And the market value is how much it was? Market value is 200. This 200 is common for both equity shares and retained profit. That is, this 200 is common for 120 and 30. That is, 200 is common for 150. So if we want to know the market value of equity share, then we should multiply by 120, which would give the market value of equity shares as 160, and the market value of retained profit would be 200 by 150 into 30, which is 40. So we'll fit them there. Then we can have the market value of preference shares, which is 10.4 lakh, and debentures, which is 33.75 lakh. So we have the total market value, which is 2 crore 44 lakh 15 thousand. Here we'll fit all the cost which we have calculated. The cost of equity is 18.5%, whereas cost of retained profits is 18%, cost of preference shares is 14.3%, and cost of debenture is 11%. All these we have calculated in working note 1, 2, 3 and 4 respectively. Next, we can calculate total cost. Total cost is nothing but this book value multiplied by the cost. For book value cost, and for market value, it is market value multiplied by cost. So the total cost for equity shares is 120 multiplied by 0.185, and it is 22.2. For retained profits, it is 5.4. For preference shares, it is 1.29. And for debentures, it is 3.96. Similarly, we'll have the total here. The total is 32.85. So this 32.85 is the cost that has been incurred for the funds that were raised at book value at 195. So if you compute the overall cost of capital, it is 32.85 divided by 195, and the cost works out to 16.85%. Similarly, let us find the total cost based on market value multiplied by cost. That is, 160 into 18.5% is 29.6, 40 into 18% 7.2, 10.4 into 14.3% 1.49, and 33.75 into 11%, which is 3.71, and total cost is 42. So 42 is the cost when compared with market value. So overall cost of capital taking market value will be 42 divided by 244.15 and it is 17.2%. Thank you.
Are you struggling in understanding financial management concepts like time value of money, financial ratio analysis, cash flow analysis, fund flow analysis, cost of capital and capital structuring decisions, capital budgeting, and working capital management? Then this course is for you. Financial Management: A Complete Study. One of the comprehensive course in financial management at the most affordable price with lifetime access. Explore and enroll now.